This is the first video I'm doing that I might expect some hate on, because I'm gonna talk about me being jobless and disabled, and I don't know, maybe that's controversial or something. Hi everyone, in this video I will be talking about everything I've done in the past 5 months, not including this month, because I am a spreadsheet artist. But first I want to show you the super cute outfit that I crocheted. It took me about 100 hours in total to make this whole set. But yeah, I will get my PowerPoint, and in the meantime I'm gonna show you a time-lapse or a part of a time-lapse of a painting that I did, because my camera battery died and I wasn't home, so I only recorded as much as I could. But I wanted to keep this video kind of interesting and still relevant to me being an artist, so I recorded a little time-lapse of me doing a painting. I want to do this video to be a little bit educational, I don't know, also because it's kind of fun since I timed everything and now I have all this information and I don't really know what to do with it, so I'm just gonna make a video about it and hope that some people are interested in the life of someone who is autistic and disabled. I'm gonna take my laptop and I'm gonna try to do a screen recording. I'm also kind of stressed to do the screen recording somehow.
That I'm not gonna do it right or something.
Okay, so I think you can see my slideshow now, so I'm gonna start it and hope that my OBS is recording it. Guys, this is me after filming for over half an hour, and now I'm seeing that I didn't even record my whole screen. I didn't adjust my settings on OBS, and I don't know how I messed up so badly, even though I was so stressed about the screen recording, and then I somehow still did it wrong. So I'm just gonna import images of my slideshow, and it's gonna be less dynamic, and I did the fun transitions for nothing, because this is what it looks like, how I recorded it. So yeah, I'm just gonna import images. Welcome to everything I've done in the past 5 months, from November to April, a presentation by Hippie Hooray. Someone who has a lot of time on their hands, or had a lot of time on their hands, I'll explain later. Okay, now it's time for the introduction. I am Hippie Hooray, or Eva. I am 27 years old. I live in Belgium with my boyfriend and cats, and somehow we were able to buy a house, although I wasn't working, but my boyfriend works full-time. I had a late autism diagnosis and suspecting ADHD, so I have my autism diagnosis, and my doctor says I probably also have ADHD. And it often goes together. I almost don't know any person who only has autism or ADHD, but that's just my personal experience. And my autism has become my only characteristic trait. I have been uploading weekly for 2 years now on YouTube, and I really love doing it, but I might have to adjust my schedule a little bit as I'm gonna start working again, because I will have a lot less time. I have been working full-time for YouTube, especially the last year, because like I didn't have a job, so I could put all my time and effort into making art and YouTube videos. And the last fact about me is that I'm vegetarian, but I really dislike falafel and vegetables. Okay, so disclaimers, there's no hate allowed on jobless people underneath this video, or any of my videos, thank you. I have not really been talking about being jobless online that much, so, and there's a reason, but yeah, in this video I'm offering my privacy to you guys, like I always do. Step one for me was to get an autistic burnout, which kind of means that everyday stuff like going to your job, doing household stuff, makes you burnt out, and I definitely had that. There were other things really contributing to my burnout that I'm not gonna talk about in this video, because it's kind of like a complicated thing, autistic burnout and burnout in general, really hard to explain and talk about. But I have done a few half-time jobs in the past. I have never worked full-time, I have also been self-employed in the past and worked half-time jobs and being self-employed at the same time, and I've done a lot of different things in the past and nothing really turned out to be very doable for me in the past. So when I got my autistic burnout, when I started to recover a little bit, I was thinking maybe I can do YouTube as a job or maybe become self-employed again, but I got humbled very quickly because my brand didn't really grow that much online, and I was really counting on the fact that I would grow online and then build my brand based on the reach that I had online, but that just never really happened. I mean, I did grow, but not to the point where I could just become self-employed again. Then eventually my mental health improved, and last year I actually started to feel a lot better, especially when I took YouTube, crocheting and my art more seriously. And then I decided to start a trajectory for disabled people to go back to work, and also just people who have trouble keeping a job, which is me. And I started that trajectory almost a year ago now, and at this point I started a new internship, which I actually really enjoy, and it's not stressing me out that much, which is a very good sign. That's very assuring for me, since I haven't had that many good experience with working before. And then the thought of going back to work scares me, but I'm proud of the steps I'm taking. Maybe I just need to find a job that's not super stressy, because I have done, like in the past, I have been a teacher without a teaching degree. I have worked far away without having a driver's license. I have done the call center. I have done all kinds of jobs that were way too stressy for me, but all because I had to hurry to find a job, because obviously we needed the money. And yeah, I have done a lot of different jobs that were way above my level. How is it going? The trajectory goes very slow because I started it a year ago, but I do need a lot of time to adjust going back to work. The only things I don't struggle with are hobbies and things I'm interested in, which is kind of typical for a lot of autistic people. I have no other choice than going back to work sooner or later. I did write this before knowing we are also going to expand our house, so now it's needed more than ever, and then I'll probably also have to become self-employed besides going back to work, which I don't really want to think about now, and I'll see if I can handle it, of course, but we will have a lot of costs, because I'm not going to spoil that much. I'm just gonna say we're gonna expand our house, but maybe if things are settled and like signed and confirmed, I'm gonna explain our plans into detail. Okay, and then blah blah blah. Am I a superwoman? Because yeah, I hope this video can give some perspective into the weaknesses and superpowers of an autistic person.
Also, what I did in time was eating, making or stuff like making lunch, hygiene stuff like washing myself, doing my makeup, gaming or scrolling on social media, sleeping. I sleep approximately like 9 to, I would say, 11 hours at night. Also not talking or chatting to people, and also not having a mental breakdown or meltdown, and also car, bike and foot rides were included in the timed sections.
I also used the app Toggle to time everything I've done. I really love the app, it's very easy to use. And you can have an overview of like every week and every month and stuff like that. Average daily hours recorded was 8 hours and 50 minutes, so kind of like a 9-to-5. Okay, so here are the average weekly hours. First, I have crocheting. My average time crocheting per week was 26 hours, which already is a lot more than I'm doing now, now that I have started my internship and doing other stuff as well. But I really love crocheting. It's basically autistic stimming while watching your favorite YouTubers. I watch YouTube all day, every day, and in the meantime I like to crochet because it keeps my hands busy and it's very relaxing, and it doesn't need brain power at all, unless you're making your own design, which I have done before. My average timing out of the house, so for example going for walks, going to the city, meeting up with family or friends, was 12 hours. I really enjoy going for a walk and listening to music. or having a solo date in the city. It's one of my other tools to unwind. Going to concerts and more are also included in this, but they drain me a lot easier, and I mainly go to concerts because my boyfriend goes to them and then I join him. But it can be quite draining for me, and also seeing family and friends can be kind of draining for me. I'm definitely very introverted, but it can still be fun, of course. Okay, now housekeeping. This is interesting. I have only done 9 hours a week of housekeeping on average, and I'm going outside the house more than doing house chores. But I have a lot of difficulties doing household tasks, including cooking. I only cook about 1 to 3 times a week, but every time I cook, it is very good though. Also, my mom sometimes helps me. She comes here about once a month. So my parents come here once a month to help me out with like cleaning and everything, because I never have the motivation to do so. The drawing that I did was about 3.5 hours per week. Most of the time my drawings take 1 to 2.5 hours to create. And I always say I want to draw more, but I need a lot of more motivation to actually get started with the drawing. And I also don't have that much inspiration usually. So I try to draw at least once a week. I hope I can draw this week because it has been so chaotic already. And it's really a challenge for me to put drawing in my schedule, although I see myself as an illustrator. But it's just really hard for me to actually make time for it, to get an idea, to make sketches and everything. It can be quite draining for me. And also I'm thinking to become self-employed again, which will probably be freelance illustration, so it will probably become more than 3.5 hours on average. I don't know how I'm gonna handle everything at the same time, you guys, but I'll see if I'll be able to become self-employed again, because I did enjoy it in the past, but this was my main job, freelance illustration. It just didn't earn me enough money back then. And other creative projects took me about 6 hours on average weekly. Because I want to collect every creative hobby ever. A few examples are like this fake stained glass art piece that I did. I also like to sew. I've done diamond painting. Now I'm doing paint by numbers. I've worked with clay. I've done a lot of like random hobbies, creative hobbies, just to have some fun. And then, for example, social media, TikTok, and Instagram. I did N in Dutch, but I mean and. Instagram creating is about 2 hours on average weekly. So that includes making TikToks, posting Instagram posts, or making pictures for Instagram or TikTok. And then YouTube, which includes filming and editing, is about 7.5 hours weekly. But I mean YouTube, just filming and editing, but it doesn't include filming for projects that I already timed, for example, crochet projects. So I put a lot more time into my YouTube channel if you also include the separate projects that I timed. For example, the crochet projects or the crafty projects or drawing. And working out is about 1 hour a week. We try to go to the gym once or twice a week. But sometimes it can be a challenge because our schedule is so busy and we're also renovating. And we also still want to have a life, so we go out quite often during the weekends. So working out is about 1 hour, which still is nice. It's better than nothing. And I'm so proud that after about 2 years, I'm still going to the gym. I have no improvement when it comes to my strength or muscles, but I just do it to not get a heart attack. So here are some stats about my best and worst weeks. The week I did the most was March 18th to March 24th, and it was 70.5 hours. I don't know what I was doing during that week. What drug was I taking? Probably none, because I'm straight edge, but I did so much during that week of March. And then the week I did the least, which I was like, I timed the least, was November 20th till November 26th. And March was the most active week because, whoa, on average I did 86 no, 68.5 hours timed per week on average. I don't know how I did that much in March. I was going crazy back then. How long do I spend on my projects? Let's find out. Crochet projects, not items, that took me the longest was this three-piece set that took me 120 hours. So it includes a top, a little vest thingy, shorts and a skirt. It took me 120 hours in total, and I remember being so tired of this project. But those videos, I did about 3 videos for this project, and those got me the most views I think so far on my YouTube channel. And then I also did my first crochet pattern that I've written, which isn't online to purchase yet, by the way. It was the smiley vests, and that also almost took me 120 hours, and that includes the smiley vest for me. I also did a matching skirt for me, then I did a matching vest for Mona, which is my cat, and then I also did a vest for my boyfriend, but I have to adjust it a little bit because it came out way too big. My average timing per crochet item is almost 20 hours. I have seen a TikTok a few days ago of someone saying, this is my longest crochet project and it was 24 hours. My average timing per item is 20 hours. For me, that's quite quickly. I was so impressed by that person crocheting so quickly, apparently. But okay, my total crocheted items I recorded is 28. So over the past 5 months, I've made 28 crocheted items. I crocheted about 1.4 items per week on average. And my quickest crochet make was 1 hour and 18 minutes. And it was a flower bookmark. So creative projects besides crochet that took me the longest. I did in a vlog make a dream project and zine that took me almost 22 hours. So I made a whole set of, I made a zine, I made stickers, I made some other items as well. I'm gonna link the video in the description of the vlog in which I make the zine and the whole dream project. It was based on my dreams, basically. Then also this dress, made out of my own sketches. It was a custom fabric. It took me 20 hours to make. Okay, how long do I spend on household tasks? So on average, I spent about 1.5 hours every week in the grocery store. Then cooking is about 1.75 hours every week, so almost 2 hours. Organizing my medication, 5 hours and 20 minutes in the past 5 months. Then least recorded on the Toggle app was reading, 2.5 hours in total in the past 5 months. I thought that I was gonna be in my reading girl era, but I started reading and then I just never picked it up again. And then finally, the pie chart, where we have all been waiting for, obviously. Crocheting and watching YouTube is 24%. Being out of the house is 16%, which is very much. Then doing household stuff, 12%. Working on my YouTube channel, so separately filming for videos like I'm doing now, or editing is 10% of my time. Crafting, 6%. Drawing, 5%. Social media creating for Instagram and TikTok, for example, is 3%. Extra is 3%. That also includes doing admin and mails and stuff like that. And then I think I also have working out and renovating, which I think both are 2%. And how long did I spend making this PowerPoint? 1 hour and 43 minutes, because of course that's a super important detail to know. And that's the end of my PowerPoint, so I'm gonna stop my recording now. But yeah guys, I'm gonna wrap up this video because there was so much talking. I'm actually wondering if someone will be able to watch this whole video. I don't know why I'm recording this, but I have put so much work into this video, so it has to go online. Please let me know in the comments if you're gonna time your activities as well, because to me it's honestly so fascinating. And I hope it was somehow a little bit interesting, because now that I've talked about it, I feel like nobody will care and will just click off the video. But Normally I do a lot of crafty videos and crochet and drawing videos and also vlogs, art vlogs. So please subscribe if you're interested in that and if you want to support a neurodivergent artist who is now jobless, but I'm working towards getting a job, which is exciting and terrifying at the same time. And I hope you have a good day or night, and I'll see you in next week's video. Bye bye! Also, do you see my little hair clip? That is a pencil. It's a ceramic pencil. It's amazing.